Welcome to Safety and Health in Engineering, part of University Malaysia Sarawak Massive Open Online Course Project. My name is Hafiz, and with me is Yonis and Nazrin, who will be guiding you throughout the course. We are from the Department of Electrical and Electronic Engineering, Faculty of Engineering, UNIMAS. In the engineering field, there is always the possibility or risk for the workers, be it the employers or employees, or even the public, to be exposed to a certain hazards. Therefore, it is really important for us to learn about safety and health related topics in order to understand, to increase the awareness, to develop procedures in order to protect the people from illness, injury, and also to reduce or avoid property damage. This course is designed mainly for engineering students and also to those who are interested in learning about the history and fundamentals of the current health and safety practice in various engineering operations in Malaysia and other parts of the world. Throughout this course, you will learn to understand the nature and concepts of the current safety and health practice. You will also learn how to select safe working procedures that suits various engineering situations. Finally, you will be able to analyze engineering activities for the identification of hazards and assessment of risks. This course consists of 6 main units, which will cover the following topics. I will do the introduction to occupational safety and health legislation, and also the occupational safety and health management system, and hazard identification and risk assessment.
And this unit will be covered the electrical safety and the environment safety in the lab. So in this unit will be explanation about the issue associated with the bore electrical safety in the lab. In addition, they describe the type of the electrical hazard, and also in the end will be definition for the electrical safe lab conditions.
In this topic, personal protective equipment, we will cover on the types of the PPE, selection and use of the PPE, basic types of the PPE, limitations of the PPE, and requirements for the storing and maintaining the PPE.
We hope that you enjoy the course and able to gain knowledge out of it.
If there are any questions, feel free to ask me, Nadreen or Harper, and we try to assist you as best as we can.
Looking forward to see you in this course.